As far as Lebanon is concerned, and I can talk for Lebanon, the relationship between Saudi Arabia and the Gulf in general and Lebanon goes long way back. And those countries have had a lot to do with the stability of Lebanon, investments in Lebanon, and a long-standing friendship at political level and social level and economic level. So the Lebanese economy, the Lebanese society in general is quite well entrenched and connected to the Gulf. We have a lot of expatriates who work in the Gulf, a lot of businesses and business relationships, as well as political and cultural relationships and tourism and investments that come from the Gulf to Lebanon. So this is not an intervention as such, as we call it, as much as it is a relationship situation, whereby this relationship had its ups and downs depending on the rhetoric that comes out of certain parties in Lebanon. Particularly, this was triggered after strong negative rhetoric from Hezbollah in Lebanon against Gulf countries and Saudi Arabia in particular. So that had caused a lot of discontent in the relationship at some point in time. We consider this to be a past event. Now we're looking forward to rebuilding that positive relationship with Saudi Arabia. We count on the support of Saudi Arabia, and we believe that Saudi Arabia has always supported Lebanon positively. It is not an intervention as much as it is always a positive support to allow the Lebanese to solve their own problems within a stabilized environment. Now, when we talk about a statement or a position by Saudi Arabia towards Lebanon, it has always been following positions coming out of Lebanon, which sometimes the Lebanese government does not have full control over. But now we've gone back, as I said, to the principles upon which this government was formed, which is basically not to take negative positions against any Arab countries and not to interfere in any of the regional conflicts and focus on the internal issues, run the elections and regain internal confidence from the public. So those are the principles that we've formed the government on. Post-resignation of our prime minister, we've gone back to those principles, we've fortified those principles, and that was one of the reasons he went back on his resignation and continued with this government, and we support that decision, of course.
So essentially you're saying that you have the support of Hezbollah and Hassan Nasrallah to continue in your endeavors in terms of the elections coming up and attempting to keep a stable government. They're not going to put any roadblocks in your way.
At this point in time, they have accepted in principle those points. We cannot guarantee, and there are no guarantees, that they wouldn't change their mind at any point in time. So basically that's
something, a tough sell for international investors if you can't really guarantee. Yeah,
that's always a tough sell. And this is why I said this is not a pure Lebanese issue. It's always an international community issue, an international problem, because nothing comes out of nowhere. You know, this situation has been building up over the last 30 years. It's not something that happened overnight, over a couple of weeks or months. So it hasn't, an organization like Hezbollah hasn't been, created overnight. It's been building up for a long time. It's been entrenched now within parts of the Lebanese society in certain regions, etc. And they are part of the fabric which needs to be addressed. And our position has always been that no arms outside the sovereign decision of the government and the Lebanese army. This is solution number one, and there's no other compromise on this one. So no one can decide on war or peace in Lebanon but the Lebanese army, but the Lebanese government, and through its official and formal military forces. And that's the only long-term stabilizing factor that we believe in. And that's something we keep working towards. And we hope that any action taken by the international community, any country in the world towards Lebanon, would take into account that Lebanon is a democracy, that Lebanon has banking institutions, that has solid institutions in place that can be negatively impacted by any action towards it. So any actions, any policies towards parts or towards constituents of Lebanon should take into account also the rest of the country and the stabilization of the institutions of that country. Definitely it's a tough sell, but at the same time there's a strong will from the international community to support Lebanon stabilizing itself and going over this period as safely and in the most stable way possible.
Are you confident that the United States understands that in terms of whether or not there'll be further sanctions on Hezbollah that caused some destabilization early on? And questions over the banking sector as well. There were a lot of questions about even your central bank governor being reelected or put back in office the last time around, I want to know, and I'm sure international investors want to know, that the United States is understanding of the challenges that you face, because if they put sanctions in place once again, you're going to have further destabilization, aren't you?
Well, further sanctions depends on what they intend to do, and we cannot dictate on the United States what they wish to do, because that's their choice. What we can do is explain to them what I've just said. We hope that any action taken by the United States takes into account the stability of the banking sector in Lebanon, the stability of the economy of Lebanon, because you cannot, you know, address one part by addressing the entirety of the country, and that may have negative effects. We do not subscribe to the point or to the idea that Hezbollah in government is a stabilizing factor. No. Hezbollah in government is the part of the Lebanese population that through the democratic process of Lebanon have made it to this government. But Hezbollah as a militarized entity in Lebanon is something that we, in principle, at least the party I represent, do not accept, because we are very, very clear about our position with respect to having the Lebanese army as the only entity that carries arms in Lebanon, and the government, the sovereign government, has the only decision for stability, for military action or wars or peace. However, we hope that the United States administration is understanding or understands the situation. We also hope that the U.S. administration keeps on engaging positively in stabilizing the region. We know that other countries in the region, like Syria, have a major destabilizing factor on Lebanon, yet we've been trying to avoid that destabilization as much as possible. With the largest refugee per capita population in the world being in Lebanon, more than 1.5 million refugees for a population of 4 million, that's significant. The host community is getting tired of that. The infrastructure has been exhausted. The international donor community has also been exhausted and getting tired of that. We need a solution in Syria as quickly as possible, and hence that solution would reflect positively on a permanent stabilizing solution in Lebanon as well. So all this needs to be taken account by the U.S., taken into account by the U.S. administration, not just one or two factors. And I do hope that this strategy and this view is clear quite soon, and we've been doing our best to communicate that message.
Hey there, thanks for checking out CNBC on YouTube. Be sure to subscribe to stay up to date on all of the day's biggest stories. You can also click on any of the videos around me to watch the latest from CNBC. Thanks for watching.